So let's have a look at the string section. The string section of the orchestra consists of violins, violas, cellos, and double bass. Did you know the violin is the highest of the string instruments and it is made from wood? It has a range of 5 octaves and the violins play more notes than anyone else in the orchestra. It is not the loudest of instruments, which is why you need so many of them in the orchestra playing together. To make a violin, you need over 70 pieces of wood. The most famous violin maker was Stradivarius, and his violins have sold for over £9 million. The violin has 4 strings, G, D, A, and E, and you use a bow to pull along the strings to make the sound. Famous violinists include Nigel Kennedy, Nicola Benedetti, Itzhak Perlman, and Andrew Rieu. Here is Nigel Kennedy. That was Nigel Kennedy playing The Winter from the Four Seasons. An amazing violinist, and as you can see, a violinist can play incredibly quickly, and it was making all of the sort of high sounds for the orchestra. Now we're going to move on to the viola. Did you know the viola is similar to the violin, but it is slightly larger, and it plays the middle range of notes in the orchestra. It has a range of 5 octaves, but a more mellow sound than the violin. To make a viola, you need over 70 pieces of wood. The viola has 4 strings, a C, G, D, and A. So the C string is a little bit lower, but the violin has an E string, which is higher. And you use a bow to pull along the strings to make the sounds. Famous viola players include Nicola Paganini, Paul Hindemith, and Kim Kashkashian. Here is a clip of the viola. As you can hear, the viola sounds a little lower than the violin and a little bit more mellow. The cello. Did you know this is a large instrument too big to fit under your chin, so it has a spike that comes out of the bottom and rests on the floor, and you grip the cello with your legs. The cello plays the low notes in the orchestra. This is known as the bass line. The cello is made over 70 different pieces of wood. The cello has four strings, C, G, D, and A, the same as the viola, but they are a lot lower. The cello also has a range of five octaves. Famous cellists include Yo-Yo Ma, Julian Lloyd Webber, and Jacqueline Dupre. This is a short clip of the cello. As you can hear from the clip, the cello is very, very low. The double bass. Did you know? This is the largest instrument in the entire orchestra and is taller and wider than a grown man. To play it, you have to sit on a high stool. It is really big, as the instrument makes the lowest of all the notes in the orchestra. The strings are about 2 meters long and are really thick to make the low notes. There are over 70 different pieces of wood needed to make the double bass. The double bass has a range of four octaves. The four strings are E, A, D, G, but they're set up backwards from the violin. Famous bass players include Willie Dixon, Giovanni Bottesini, and Domenico Dragonetti. Here is a little clip of the double bass. As you can hear, the double bass is very low and very, very tall. You could see how thick the strings were, so it could make those low notes. Thank you. And that was Mr. Simons conducting at the Royal Albert Hall with his string orchestra. As you can hear, it sounds very, very powerful when all the strings play together. But for now, we shall leave the string family and we will head to the woodwind. The woodwind family. Over the years, this family has grown a lot in the orchestra. But today, I'm going to talk about the four main instruments. The flute, the oboe, the clarinet, and the bassoon. So let's start with a flute is technically any open tube that you blow into to produce sound, even an empty bottle of Coke. A flute playing musician is called a flute player, flutist, a flautist, a flutter, or a flutinist. The flute was one of the first musical instruments ever invented and has been used for thousands of years. Ancient Sumerians, Egyptians, Greeks, Indians, Chinese and Japanese all used early versions of today's flutes. Many different cultures have their own take on the flute, and many of them developed independently from one another. The major Hindu deity Krishna holds a bamboo flute. It is been said that Krishna created the world through the beautiful sound of the flute, and that the flute preaches love and freedom. The standard concert flute has a range of about 3 octaves. The flute is one of the highest pitched instruments. Consequently, flute music is written in treble clef. The piccolo is basically a mini flute and sounds 1 octave higher than the standard concert flute. When piccolo players play flute music, the notes sound 1 octave higher. Throughout history, flutes have been made of bone, ivory, wood, jade, glass, plastic, brass, nickel, silver, gold, or even platinum. Now, let's hear the flute. You can hear just how high the flute can go in that clip. Now, let's move on to the next instrument, the clarinet. The clarinet is a musical instrument considered to be a woodwind type of instrument because of the way music is made with a single reed mouthpiece. In order to produce the sound, the clarinetist blows into the mouthpiece and uses their fingers to play the rings and keys to produce different sounds. Single reed instruments date back to ancient Greece, but the modern clarinet was developed from the Chalumia in the late 17th century after modifying its design. There is debate as to who the true inventor of the clarinet is, with some believing it was a German instrument maker named Johann Christoph Denner, and others believing it was actually his son Jacob Denner. In 1791, Mozart was already a fan of the instrument, and it didn't take long for other composers and musicians to follow. Now let's hear a little clip of the clarinet.
Thank you.
So that was the clarinet. Let's move on to the oboe. The oboe is a musical instrument of the woodwind family. It is classified as a double reed woodwind instrument. The clarinet was single, but the oboe is a double reed, two pieces of very thin wood that vibrate together. The oboe was first referred to as a hautboys when it appeared in the 1600s. It spread quickly throughout Europe and was known by a variety of names, including hautboy, hautboit, hautboy, and hautboy. Until the clarinet was invented, it was the military band's main instrument. The body of the oboe has three main parts, including the bell, lower joint, and upper joint. From the 1800s on, the oboe has served as the tuning note in an orchestra. Let's hear a clip of the oboe. As you could see, the oboe was a little bit thinner than the clarinet, and it's got a more penetrating sound. Let's move on to the last instrument, the bassoon. The bassoon is a musical instrument in the woodwind family. Many believe the bassoon to be derived from the dulcian, which is another double reed woodwind instrument from the 1500s, but others believe the bassoon was a completely new invention. It is commonly believed that the true inventor of the bassoon was Martin Hortateur, that created the first bassoon in the 1650s in four sections: a wing joint, a boot, a bass joint, and bass. In the 1800s, the bassoon was refined for use in concert halls and for greater playability. The bassoon is used in a variety of musical styles, including classical, jazz, modern, and popular music. Let's hear a little clip of the bassoon. As you could hear from the bassoons, because they're so large, they make the low sounds of the orchestra. So you have the four instruments: the clarinet, the bassoon, the flute, and the oboe.